So basically today we discuss a which one topic. Today we start a subnetting part. Okay. Basically first we start from class C, then class B, then class A. So basically if you want to learning a subnetting from scratch. So basically we are just follow a which one formula. This one is subnetting formula. So a subnetting rule is, okay. First condition is decimal to binary. How to convert a decimal to binary? We discuss. Then second, we discuss what is the meaning of a bar or bit. Clear? A third concept we discuss a default subnet mask. Convert into custom subnet mask. Okay, right now then we discuss fourth point. Which one? Increment bit. Then we discuss a fifth number. This one is last part of subnetting. A block size. Inside block size, we are getting a three information. Which one? First we are getting a network address, then we are getting a valid IP, then we are getting broadcast. So this one is address, this one address, and this one address. Clear? So how many address we are getting in block size, network, valid, and broadcast? So first thing, one by one we discuss. So first we need to learn a decimal to binary. How to convert decimal to binary? A very simple. First we learn into how many bits? Only 4 bit. How many bits? Aaron, Ibrahim, Rajendra ji. How many bits we are using to learn a decimal to binary? Only 4 bits. This 4 bit, if I am putting a formula, a 2 power 4, so I am getting some values, but this 4 bit represent from 0, 1, 2, and this one is 3. So how many values we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I am putting 2 power 0, so how many values come out? 1. If I am putting 2 power 1, so how many values come? 2. 2 power 2, how many values? A 4. A 2 power 3, how many values? Aaron, 8. This one is simple. Okay, in 4 bits, this value is represent 1, 2, 4 and then 8. Clear? Okay. Right now, one more thing. Basically, a decimal means it's a numerical number. Which one? A numerical values. And binary means 0 and 1. Which one? 0 and 1. Okay. Right now, if I'm suppose calling on, so that means 1. If I am calling off, that means 0. Clear? Okay. Right now, suppose this value is fixed. Okay. So right now we are learning from decimal to binary. Very simple. Here we write down decimal value. And this one we write down into only 4 bit values. 1, 2, 4, and then 8. Okay. Suppose if you are getting a decimal value is 2. So which one bit on or off? 1 is on or off? Which one? A 2 means which one value match a lower or higher? A 2 means if I am calling 1. So this one is lower. Yes or no? Okay. Right now, suppose if I am off this bit, that means 0. If I am on a 2 number bits, so that means 2 or 2 match. Yes or no? Okay. Right now, 4 in use? No. 8? No. Okay. Right now, suppose if you are getting a decimal value is 4. So which one bit on? Rajendra ji, Aaron, which one bit on or off? 1 is on or off? 4. So 1 is off, 2 is off, and 4 is match. 1. This one is 0. Suppose if you are getting a decimal value is 7. So convert into binary. Oh, very simple. Seven only plus values. A one is on or off? One. One is on. Two on. One plus two. How many values? Three. Three plus four. How many values? Seven. And eight is zero. Suppose if I am getting a decimal value is nine. So which one value on or off? One is on or off? Anyone know? Only nine value. If you do plus, no issue. Just do plus. Okay. Nine means a one is on and two is off, higher, four higher, then eight is on. Okay. This one is 4-bit values. Okay. Right now, one more thing. Suppose if you are getting a 11 number. So convert into decimal to binary. Which one bit on or off? 11. One is on or off? One is on, two is on, one or two plus three, four is seven or eight, 15. No, four is off and eight is on. Okay, right now decimal value is 13. Then 13, one, zero, one, 8 plus 4, 12 and plus 1, how many values? 13. Okay. In 4 values, how many maximum values you are getting? A maximum is 15. If you are getting a decimal value is 16, so not possible to convert into binary with the help of 4 bits. Clear? Okay. Right now, one more thing. Suppose if you are getting a this one values, now we learn from 8 bit. How many bits? 8 bit. So in 8 bit, how many values available? 0 to 7. How to represent 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this one is 7. If I'm putting a 2 power 0, that means 1. 2 power 1, 2. 2 power 2, 4. 2 power 3, how many? 8. A 2 power 4, 16. A 2 power 5, 32. 2 power 6, 64. And 2 power 7, how many values? 128. Clear? Okay. Again, represent this values. So I'm starting from higher value. So higher value is 128, then 64, then 32, then 16, then 8, 4, 2, 1. Clear? Again, same concept. 0 means bit is off and 1 means a bit is on. Clear? Okay. Right now, suppose if I am getting a decimal values here, decimal values, a decimal value is 4. So which one bit on or off? 128 is on or off? It's a higher value or lower value? Which one? Higher, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 4 is equal 1, 0, and 0. So right now, this decimal value, a binary is percent. Clear? Okay. Right now, if you are getting a decimal value is 16. So which one bit on or off? 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, and 0. 16 is available. Suppose if you are getting a decimal value is 19. Then which one? 0, 0. This one is higher values. This one also. 16 is a lower. On how many values remaining after 16 minus 19? 3 values. So 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. Right now, suppose if you are getting 34, then 128, 0, 64, 32 is on, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. 32 plus 2, 34. If you are getting, suppose 69, so how to convert? Same, 0, 1, 0. After 64 minus into 69, a 5 values, 0, 0, 4 is, yes, lower value. That means use how many values remaining? Only one. So this one is 0 and this one is 1. Suppose if you are getting a value is 130, or suppose 95, then 128, 64 and 32, 96. So you need to off 80, 88, and then 92, 94, and this one is 95 plus the values. Okay, if you are getting 102, then 0, 0, 1, 1, 96, 96, and then 16, 112. Yes or no? So we need to just turn off. And 96 plus 8, how many? 104. So need to off. On, this one is on, and this one is off. Suppose if you are getting 130, that condition, 128 is on. Yes or no? 0 0 0 0 0 1 and then 0. Clear this thing? Aaron, Ibrahim, Rajendra ji, clear? A decimal to binary? Any doubt? Decimal to binary. Okay. Right now, first step we clear. Which one? Decimal to binary. Okay. Right now, second process is a borrow bit. A borrow bit, how to get a borrow bit? A coming from this side and get a first on bit. On bit means this one is off and this one is on. First on bit position number. So right now this one is first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and then eight. Because right now how many bits we are using? 8 bit. So right now for four, a borrow bit is how many? Coming from this side, off, and this one is on. A position number is 3. So borrow bit, how many bits? 3. Right now, anyone know this one borrow bit for 16? How many borrow bit? Borrow bit for 16. If you are getting a 16 value, how many borrow bit? Position number only. Which one value first on? Coming from this side, and this one is first on. A position number is 5th. This one, 19 borrow bit, how many? Same as it is 5th. Okay. Right now, this one borrow bit. Anyone know? Ibrahim, Aaron, or Rajendra ji? Coming from this side, and verify which one position number? First on bit. First on bit. 6th number, a very good Aaron. This one. Position number is a 6. A very simple. Right now, this one 7. 7, 7. And this one is borrow bit is 8. So, how to get a borrow bit is clear? A very simple. Right now, how many tasks we need to complete? Decimal to binary, then borrow bit. Okay. Suppose if you want to take a more practice, so how to do? A very simple. I have some notebooks for IP addressing. Hold on. So this one is subnetting book, a 58 pages subnetting book. If you want to make a master in subnetting, this book will be helpful. Right now, open IP address details, private address, subnet mask. Okay. Right now, last time we discussed, okay, right now, binary to decimal. How it possible binary to decimal? Oh, very simple. Right now, I'll calculate the on bit. Suppose I just want to make this one, binary to decimal. So right now, 4 number on, then 2 number, and then 1 number. So decimal value is 7. Suppose this one, 32, 16, and 8. 32 plus 16, 48 plus 8, 56. 56 plus 2, 58 plus 1, how many? 59. So binary to decimal is very simple. Right now, how many questions are available? Verify this one. Now, after binary to decimal, we need to learn decimal to binary. Oh, very simple. Right now, 15. So 128 is off, higher value. 64 higher. 32 on. 16 on. 32 plus 16, 48. So this one off, off, and this one is on, and this one is off. So decimal to binary is done. Okay, right now after decimal to binary. So this one, I think I already discussed in last class. Address class identification. So which class of this address? Class C. You need to solve these questions. Okay, then. A network portion, host portion question. This one is network and this one is host. So this one is class C. So 3 octet network and 1 octet for host. So only host post portion is circle, only network portion circle. Okay. Okay, this one is default subnet mask. Okay. Right now, after decimal to binary and borrow bit, we need to learn a which one task? Default subnet mask convert into customized subnet mask. Why we do these things? Because last time we are getting an IP address wastage. Which one task? IP address wastage. So that is the reason network engineer get a email from network admin. Email, inside email, how many users IP required? Read the lines. Aaron, how many users IP address required? How many? 20 user IP address. Okay. So how to get 20 user IP address? Very simple. If you are receiving any email, any requirement. So first verify a number of users IP. Users means I'm doing host. Okay. Host concept always, a bit always. Bit always off. If you are getting a user concept, user means host and bit always off. Okay, right now this thing is clear. Okay, right now we start from which one class submitting first? Class C. In class C, how many octet available for free host? 1 octet. Free for host. Yes or no? 1 octet. Free for host portion. Okay, right now, very simple. Very simple. Inside 1 octet, how many bits available? 8 bits. So I think in 8-bit value, I already discussed 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. This one is first octet bit. So right now, very simple. First task to resolve this requirement, or first task, decimal to binary, very simple, step by step. Okay, right now which one is decimal value? So number of users, how many? 20. So decimal to binary convert. 128, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. Okay, now decimal to binary after second task, borrow bit. So can you please send me the message, which one is first on bit in this one? Borrow bit. A very simple, first on bit position number. Anyone know? Ibrahim, Rajendra ji, Aaron. First on bit, coming from this side.
Five.
Which one?
Five.
Very good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very good, 5 bits. Very simple. Right now, third task is default subnet mask convert into CSM. So I'm just write down DSM convert to CSM. Okay, right now, which one class we are using? Class C. Okay, class C default subnet mask. Anyone know? Default. 255.255.255.0. Okay, right now a 3 octet already fixed. And how many octet free? Only 1 octet. So this one is 1 octet. Inside 1 octet, how many bits available? 8 bit. Inside this octet, how many bits available? 8 bit. Suppose if I am represent this type 255, 255, 255, dot. And zero means all value is zero. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Because right now 8 bit available na inside this octet, one octet. So right now, second task, after represent this type, how many bits a borrow? 5 bits. And if you are doing user concept, that means host and bit always off. So right now, how many bits a borrow? A 5 bits. Coming from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. How many bits off? 5 bits off. And right now, remaining how many bits on? 1, 2, 3. Okay, very simple. Right now, very simple. This one is 128, 64, and 32. 3 bits on. So plus the values, plus the values. Now we are getting DSM to which one? CSM. So first octet as it is because already full. Second full. Third full. Inside fourth octet, how many bits on? 3 bits on. So right now 128, 64, 32. That means plus the values. How many values come out? Which one? 2 to 4. Which one value? 2 to 4. Suppose right now, if you are getting a 1 bit on, last 1 bit, this one. 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, this one. So 1 bit on. So that means how many value? 128. If you are getting a 2 values, 192. If you are getting a 3 values, 224. If you are getting a 4 values, 240. If you are getting a 5 values, 248. If you are getting a 6 value, 252. If you are getting a 7 values, 254. If you are getting 8 values, 255. So how many values on? 3 bits. For 3 bits, 224. A very simple trick. Clear this thing? Okay. Right now, DSM to CSM is clear. Now we are doing again last concept, fourth number. A fourth number task is increment bit. How to get increment bit? A very simple. 256 minus this values, only changing values. 224. How many values coming? Anyone know how many values come out? After minus 256 to 224, how many values? Aaron, Ibrahim, Rajendra ji. Anyone know how many values come out? Yes, 32. Okay. Right now, fourth concept is clear. Now, fifth number. Block size. For block size, inside block size, we are getting network, valid IP, then we are getting broadcast. So three address we are getting. A very simple. Right now your CSM is this one. CSM, write down first CSM value, customize subnet mask, 255.255.224. And right now your increment bit is how many? 32. Over reason. Right now for a 20 user, we need to get a network, broadcast and value. So right now we are using a private address. Which one? 192.168.1.0. This one address. So right now verify first octet in your customized subnet mask, full or free? Ibrahim, full or free? First octet in subnet mask?
No.
Full. 255 means full.
Okay. Full.
Second octet, full or free?
Full. Taken.
Again full. Right now third octet?
Again. Full.
But in fourth octet, 224. That means this value must be 255. Yes or no? This thing is clear? Okay. So right now, if I am getting a zero this side, so this one is my, which one address? Network address. Which one address, dear? Network address. Okay. Right now, first octet, as it is as it is 192, because full second octet as it is, third octet as it is, but inside fourth octet we need to fulfill, because right now zero. So how many bits increment? 32. Okay, before 32 which one value coming? 31. 192, 168, 1 dot 31. So dot 31 is my which one address? Broadcast. In between 0 or 31, how many values are coming? 1, 2, 3, and this type till go to 30. So that means from 1.1 to 1.30. This one is my which one IP? Which one IP, dear? A valid IP. Clear? Okay. Right now, how many bits off in my subnet mask? Default subnet mask. How many bits off? 5 bit. A very simple formula. 2 power 5 minus 2. 32 minus 2. How many valid IP? How many valid IP? 30. This one is host formula. Okay. Right now, a very simple. Why we are doing a minus? Because right now, network address never assign end devices means a PC, laptop, server. Broadcast address never assign end devices, PC, laptop, server. Clear? So this one is my first block from 1.0 to 1.31. This one is my first network, first block. Any doubt, Aaron, Ibrahim? Okay, right now how to identify? Go to ncpa.cpl and very simple trick, right? Open your network adapter. IPv4 property. Obtain, then use the following. So I'm just trying to assign 1.0 and then subnet mask is 224 customized. Read the error, dear. The combination of IP address, read the error. Ibrahim, Aaron, Rajendra Ji, please unmute your mic and read the error. Why we are getting this error?
The combination of IP address and subnet mask is invalid. All of the bits in the host address portion of the IP address are set to zero. Please enter a valid combination of IP address and subnet mask.
Yes, because right now this one is not a combination, because right now 1.0 is my which one address? Network. Suppose if you are trying to assign 1.31. So right now trying to 31, but subnet mask must be same, customized. Yes or no? So right now if I am trying 1.31 and then enter, again I am getting the combination of IP address subnet mask is invalid, because right now this one is my which one address? Broadcast 31. Yes or no? Okay. Right now how many valid IP? 192, 168, 1.12, 30. So first IP 1.1. Yes, I'm getting IP address, no issue. If I am supposed trying to assign IP 1.30 as well. So this one is method to check IP addresses. Any issue? Okay, right now we need to solve one more task. One more email. Suppose if you are getting again email, but inside email, how many users required? How many users, Rajendra Ji? 50 users. Ibrahim, how many? 50 users IP. Okay, right now which one class provide for 50 user? Again, we start from class C. A very simple. Okay, right now first task is which one? Decimal to binary. Okay, so right now value is 128, 64, 32. 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. Okay, anyone know which one bit on or off for 50? 128 off or on? Off, higher value. 64 also higher. 32 is lower. 16 also lower. So 32 plus 16, 48. This one is higher. This one is higher, this one on, and this one is off. Right now, anyone know a borrow bit? Ibrahim, Rajendra ji, Aaron, borrow bit. First on bit position number. A very simple. Tricky, but very simple. A borrow bit. Anyone know borrow bit? Coming from this side and write down the position number.
Number six.
Number six. A very simple. Six number. Very good. Right now, third task. Third task is DSM to CSM. Because right now in default subnet mask, I'm just getting a wastage of IP address to 56 address. Yes or no? So we need to convert DSM to CSM. So class C default subnet mask is 255.255.0. Inside zero, how many bits present in one octet? 8 bit. Okay, right now, if you are getting a user concept, that means I'm doing a which one task? Host. And bit always on or off. If you are getting a user, that means always, bit always off. Clear? Very simple. So right now, 8 bit, how to represent? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right now, how many bits a borrow in subnet mask? Borrow bit? 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this one is 6. 6 bits is off, and right now, how many bits on? 1, 2. Right now, we are doing DSM to CSM. First octet, full. Second, full. Third octet, full. But in fourth octet, how many bits on? Verify how many bits on? 2 bits. If you are getting a 2 bits, that means which one? This one or this one? Which one bit? Anyone know? Plus the values 128 and 64. How many values come out? 192. Very simple. Right now, fourth task. A fourth task we discuss. Which one bit? Increment bit. So increment always 256 minus how many values? 192. How many values coming, Aaron? Any idea how many values coming? Please tell me how many values come out if I'm doing minus. Anyone know how many values? Ibrahim, Rajendra ji, after 256 minus 192. 64. How many? 64. Always use calculator if you are getting any issues. A fifth number we need to convert. We need to make a which one size? Block size. A very simple. So right now we know, I already know the subnet mask detail. Suppose if I'm using this one address. 192.168.1.0. So first octet full or free in my subnet mask? Verify. Full or free? Full. Second, full. Third, full. And fourth is free. So right now, this one is my which one address? Which one address? Network. Okay. Right now, 192 as it is, 168, 1 dot. Right now, fourth is 0. That means we need to fulfill 255 till. Yes or no? So right now, increment bit is how many? 64. So right now, 64. Before 64, which one value coming? 63. 63 is my which one address? Broadcast. And how many valid IP? Anyone know how many valid IP? 1.12. 62. This one is my which one IP? Valid IP. Okay. Right now, how to know how many a valid IP available in this network? From this one is this address. This one is in use, and this one is another network. So we need to remove this one. So this one is single block. Clear? Single block. Right now, suppose if you are getting a borrow bit is 6. So write down putting the formula 2 power 6 minus 2. 64 minus 2. How many valid IP? Ibrahim, Rajendra ji, Aaron, how many valid IP?
62.
And how many need? 50. How many IP waste? Only 10 IP address. But before subnetting, we are getting 240, 250, 210 IP addresses waste. Yes or no? That is the reason most of the cases we are doing a subnetting part. So class C subnetting is clear. Any doubt here? Class C subnetting. So your task is to solve this one image. Your homework is, you need to resolve this one. Homework is, if you are getting an email for a 10 user IP, solve this one. If you are getting an email for 100 user IP, solve this one. Only class C. If you are getting an email for how many users IP? 200 user. Rajendra ji, Ibrahim, clear? Any doubt? Dear, this thing is clear? Hello, can you hear me? Please unmute your mic.
Yes, clear.
Yeah,
so this one is your homework and solve this book. Clear? So class C subnetting is clear. A very simple trick. Within a second, you are getting a subnetting part. Okay, right now, how to solve this book? So you need to go to next task, next, this one. So this one is very simple book, very simple. Right now, for example, I am just solve this single question or verify. Verify. So this one is problem number 4, custom subnet mask. Okay, no worry. Number of needed usable subnets. So skip this one. Number of needed a usable host. Host means user. How many user IP required? 30. And can you verify which class of address this one? Class B, C or A? Which one?
Class C.
Class C. Very good. Very good. Okay. Right now we are getting a 30 user requirement. So first task is D2B. D2B means decimal to binary. For 30 user, a very simple trick. Okay. 128 is of 64, 32, 16, 1, 8, 1, 1, 1, and this one is 0. Right now, second task, anyone knows second task? A borrow bit. Which one is borrow bit first? Verify borrow bit. Borrow bit position number coming from this side.
Five.
Very good. Third number, because right now 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one is 5. 5 number bit. Clear na? This one is 6, 7, 8 position number. Okay. Right now third is DSM to CSM. So verify this one is class C. So 255.255.255.0. Inside zero, how many bits? 8 bits. A very simple. Right now, how many bits a borrow? 5. And we are doing which one concept? User. User mean bit always off. Okay. Right now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this one is 8. How many bits a borrow? 5. So we need to turn off 5 bits. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one is 5. And how many bits on? 1, 2, 3. So we need to convert DSM to CSM. 255. 3 bits on means again 224. Clear? This thing is clear. A fourth number is increment bit. So 256 minus 224. How many values coming? 32 is my increment bit. Fifth number, a block. So right now we are getting this address. From this address, we need to get a network address. So right now 210.100.56.0. Now verify first octet full or free in subnet mask. Full, second full, third full. So right now 3 octet already full and fourth octet is 224. That means 210.100.56 dot increment is 32. So right now before 32, we are getting a 31. This one is broadcast and from 1 to 30 is my, which one IP? Valid. Yes or no? And this one is which one? Network. Clear? So right now default is clear, subnet mask. CSM is 224. We write down only last. Okay, right now skip this one. Number of subnet, this one. Total number of host address. So we very simple. 2 power 5 minus 2. 32 minus 2. This one is 30 valid IP. But total is how many? 32. How many usable? Only 30 assignable. A number of borrow bit, how many? A very simple. Clear? Aaron, Ibrahim, Rajendra ji. So
yes, sir.
You just need to solve this task. I already write down homework. 3 question only. 10 user IP required, 100 user or 200 user. If you solve this question easily, so you can get again emails. Suppose 35 user, 60 user, 85 user. So this time, clear? Any doubt, dear? So tomorrow we discuss class B subnetting. Which one? Aaron, Ibrahim, Rajendra ji. Which one subnetting we discuss tomorrow?
Class B.
So first solve this task, okay? Solve this question, 3 question only. Only 3 question for concept. Okay, right now we meet again tomorrow and then discuss class B, okay? Class B or class A, clear? Any issue?
Everything is clear.
Yeah, which one?
Yeah.
You need to solve this task only, okay?
Okay.
CCNA day 7, subnetting class C. We discuss tomorrow class B and A. Then we start again advanced part of subnetting. Only 3 days class for subnetting and easy to learn. Clear? Bye, dear.
Yes, clear.